Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Literature Filia, the one-stop destination for your love of literature. Today we are going to read about a very classic novel of Victorian era, Jane Eyre by Charlotte Bronte. But before moving further, I want you guys to keep in mind some key facts that will help you during the lecture. This novel is written by Charlotte Bronte and it was published in AD 1407. The novel genre consists of Gothic, Victorian, Building Roman and Romance. The major characters of this novel are Jane Eyre, Rochester, St. John River and Edward Fairfax. The most famous line of this novel is, "Readers, I married him." Let's get started. Hello everyone, so today we are going to study our new topic, that is the themes and the characters in the novel Jane Eyre. But before beginning to the topic, I would like to introduce the background again to you. Jane Eyre is an extraordinary mixture blending an imaginative vision influenced by the stories Charlotte Bronte had read when she was young with her own deeply felt personal experiences. She had grown up in a remote village reading the magazine stories of a romantic period, full of haunted castles, ghosts, and monsters like Frankenstein, which was published in 1818. From these, she got the hero with a mysterious past, the mad woman in Attic, and the wedding suddenly broken off. And like her contemporary Dickens, she relied on the coincidences to resolve the plot. But her own life was a determined struggle to retain self-respect as a teacher and governess, and she was effectively the head of her family. In the novel, Bronte combines intensity of feeling with the belief that an intelligent young woman, whose only drawback is her poverty, has as much right to express herself as a wealthy man. Themes in the novel. Here are some major themes of the novel. The first one is gender inequality. Alongside Bronte's critique of Victorian class hierarchy is a subtler condemnation of gender inequalities during the time period. The novel begins with Jane's imprisonment in the Red Room at Gateshead. And later in the book, Bertha's imprisonment in the attic at Thornfield is revealed. The connection implies that Jane's imprisonment is symbolic of her lower social class, while Bertha's contentment is symbolic of Victorian marriage. All women, if they marry under unequal circumstances, as Bertha did, will eventually be confined and oppressed by their husbands in some manner. Significantly, Jane is consciously aware of the problems associated with unequal marriages. Thus, even though she loves Mr. Rochester, she refuses to marry him until she has her own fortune and can enter into the marriage contract as his equal. Personal independence. One of the major themes of this novel is personal independence. Jane's determination to achieve an independent existence without sacrificing her principles. It is beyond her expectations that a man of her higher class should return her love, but she can only agree to live with him on equal terms. Bronte not only made Jane plain and tiny like herself, but she gave her own qualities of a sharp intelligence, a passionate nature, a clear conception of moral responsibilities, and above all, great courage and determination. We admire Jane when she stands up to Mrs. Reed and Mr. Rochester's equal in conversations. The next theme in this novel is social position. Social position, social class has been the major theme of this novel too. Most of the middle-class characters from the Reed children to Blanche Ingram look down on Jane simply because she is poor and think they have the right to humiliate her for that reason alone. Jane's love for Mr. Rochester makes her painfully aware of the boundaries of classes. Although she is Mr. Rochester's intellectual and spiritual equal, she is still socially inferior. They can only marry as equals when Jane conveniently inherits money from her uncle. The major characters in this novel are, as in the beginning of this lecture, I told you that there are many characters actually in this novel because this is a very long novel, but I would like to only keep those characters which are actually essential in reading this novel. First is Jane Eyre. The protagonist and narrator of Jane Eyre, Jane, begins the novel as an angry, rebellious 10-year-old orphan and gradually develops into a sensitive, artistic, maternal and fiercely independent young woman. In each stage of the novel, Jane is met with fierce opposition from those around her. Often because of her low social class and lack of economic independence, yet Jane maintains her independent spirit, growing stronger in her beliefs and ideals with each conflict. She rejects marriage to both Mr. Rochester and Miss St. John because she understands she will have to forfeit her independence in the unions. Only after she has attained the financial independence and self-esteem to maintain a marriage of equality, does Jane allow herself to marry Mr. Rochester and enjoy a life of love. The next character is Edward Rochester. The owner of Thornfield Manor and Jane's lover, Mr. Rochester is an interesting twist on the tragic Byronic hero. Though not handsome in a strict sense, his great passion and forcefulness makes him an extremely appealing and sensual character. Mr. Rochester is also a sympathetic character because of the mistakes he has made in the past. Deceived by Bertha Mason's external beauty, Mr. Rochester is constantly brooding and rejecting the darkness of his decision. Despite their differences in backgrounds and social status, Mr. Rochester is a kind kindred spirit to Jane and feels a sort of emotional peace when he is in her presence. Mr. Rochester is also particularly important to Jane because he provides her with the unconditional love and sense of family that she has never experienced before. Although Mr. Rochester is clearly presented as Jane's superior in intellect and worldly knowledge, the revelation of his marriage to insane Bertha Mason demonstrates that Jane possesses the moral and ethical values more than him. The next character is St. John Rivers. St. John Rivers is actually Jane's cousin. We get to know in the end of the novel that he is actually the cousin of Jane. St. John is the last of the three major Christian models Jane observes over the course of the novel. St. John's religion is far too detached for Jane. He refuses to give in to his love for Rosamond Oliver out of a warped sense of duty to God, and Jane concludes that he still knows little about God's love. While Jane admits that she would gladly accompany him as his cousin, marrying him under such circumstances would mean forfeiting her rights to a life of passion and love. He was constantly forcing Jane to marry him. Jane's rejection of St. John's advances seems to spur her return to Rochester, her one chance for spiritual passion. Thank you so much for watching, and with this, I will wrap up this lecture and this novel, and we will come with a new novel with a new topic. Thank you.
I hope you guys love the video. Please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Don't forget to press the bell icon.